Okay, so I asked you on the Instagram world, sorry, you Facebookers, but you're gonna get it anyway, if you wanted a week of me talking about emotional eating. It's what I like to call unemotional eating. And you all said yes, you would like it, except for one random Asian man who did not want to hear about emotional eating. So to you, Kung Pao Foon, I am so sorry, but I'm gonna do it anyway. Okay, so here we go. You know, lots of us talk about how we are emotional eaters. It's like this special club that we think we're a part of. It's really not that special. It's like, oh, you get to be in the club and eat emotionally. Here's 5 to 10 pounds that you can carry around. Congrats. You know, it's not really something we want to be a part of, but we claim to be. A lot of us say that we're emotional eaters. And really, if we were true emotional eaters, we would actually be feeling our emotions as we eat. But all of us that claim to be emotional eaters are actually using eating as a buffer to escape from the emotions that we don't want to feel. So, for instance, if you are feeling overwhelmed or anxious and you just don't want to feel that way, you might turn to food because for a little bit it's able to numb and buffer that experience and take you away from it all. And so, a lot of us think that we're really eating emotionally, but what's really happening is that we are escaping our emotions and going to food. Here's the downfall. Those emotions, because we haven't felt them, will still be there waiting for us when we are done eating an entire bag of chocolate, right? Been there. Anyway, so what I want to teach you this week is tips and tricks, not really tricks, just tips and tools of how to get through eating unemotionally. Okay, and turning to eating food with emotion instead of escaping from your emotions. Okay, so today's first tool that I want to share with you is taking time to stop and think before you go to food. If there is an emotion that you need to feel or something that you're escaping, if you're lonely, if you're bored, if you're sad, if you feel left out, or any of the emotions can cause us to actually leave those emotions and escape into food. And I want you to just take 5 minutes. I know I've talked to you about the 5-minute rule, but I want you to take 5 minutes and really think about those emotions. And once you allow yourself to figure out A, what the emotion is, and then sit through it and feel it for a good 5 to 10 minutes, a lot of the time that emotion will subside, and so will those hunger cues that aren't true hunger cues. What they are is the reaction that we get when we don't want to feel hard stuff. We don't want to be uncomfortable, and so we eat a lot of food and then we're uncomfortable. I know it's an oxymoron, none of it makes any sense, but it is what we've conditioned ourselves to do over time. So today, I want you to stop and feel your emotions. Figure out what it is before you reach for something, and your body will tell you whether it's true hunger or it's an emotion that you're trying to escape. Try that out today, and I'll be back with more for tomorrow.